So, thank you. So let's move on now to the subject of my presentation. And the aim of this presentation is to discuss several aspects of fertility treatment for people living with a virus, either HIV or hepatitis virus. There are some risks that have to be taken into account in this population during the fertility process. The risk to transmit the infection to the partner or to the child, the possibility that the infertility treatment has some side effects on the underlying disease process, and lastly, a more ethical question concerning the possibility that the parents become unable to care to the child given a parental illness or death. On the contrary, ART may bring some benefits in decreasing the risk of transmission to the partner or the possibility that a child could be infected, and also to early operate during pregnancy in order to reduce the transmission to the child. So in my first part of this presentation, we will discuss about ART in HIV populations, and afterwards, in the second part, we will tackle this issue in hepatitis infected patients. As you know, AIDS was first recognized by CDC in the beginning of the 80s. Then the virus was identified, and at the beginning of the epidemic, the life expectancy was low and the mother-to-child transmission was high, nearly 25%. So HIV was considered as a serious contraindication to a healthy pregnancy. With the introduction of AIDS-AT and later with combined antiretroviral therapy, the mother-to-child transmission decreased and is estimated now to be less than 1%. So today, around 34 million people are living with HIV in the world, nearly 90% are persons of active reproductive age. And according to a French recent report, around one-third of women and one-fifth of men express the desire to become parents. So things have changed, and it's true that with the introduction of an efficient therapy, I mean combined antiretroviral therapy, life expectancy and the quality of life have dramatically improved, leading to think about long-term plans. For instance, in North America and Europe, life expectancy for a man of 20 years old at the age of the diagnostic is now nearly 70 years. When the man is infected, the goal of ART is to prevent the infection to his female partner and so to the child. We know indeed that HIV is present in sperm, as three HIV RNA particles have been found in both seminal plasma and non-spermatozoan cells. But despite contradictory results on the presence of the virus in spermatozoa, it is now believed that spermatozoa do not contain HIV. Moreover, in untreated HIV-infected patients, the concentration of the virus in semen is high, around tenfold higher than the concentration in blood. Moreover, some virus has been found in seminal plasma at high level in around 9 out of 10 untreated men. So the question is, how can we reduce the risk of horizontal transmission? And I think that there are at least three means to do it. The first one is sperm processes. In order to separate the seminal plasma and non-spermatozoal cells, that may contain the virus from a motile fraction spermatozoa without any virus and that can be used in YUR or IVF. The second way is to improve HIV detection. In order to decrease the threshold of detection by new technology, and the third one is to use an efficient therapy as combined antiretroviral therapy. So what are the effects of sperm processing and improvement at HIV detection? Samprini was the first one to introduce a new sperm washing technique in order to separate the virus from the post-wash spermatozoa. And as you can see it on this table, he used a double density gradient followed by one wash and one swim up. And this technique was efficient as all the post-wash spermatozoa samples were negative for HIV detection. This study was confirmed by others who used the same or similar technique, but always using a density gradient followed by at least one wash or two washes. And as you can see it, these methods were efficient to eliminate the virus from the post-wash spermatozoa samples, even if the threshold of HIV detection was lowered. We also know that combined antiretroviral therapy is efficient to decrease viral load in both blood and seminal plasma. But there is not a strict correlation between the blood viral load and some seminal plasma viral load. As you can see it on this table with different studies, HIV viral load of patients under combined antiretroviral therapy and with an undetectable blood plasma viral load for at least 6 months were found in the seminal plasma of 5 to 31% depending on the study. So, what can we do for a couple where the man is HIV positive with childbearing desire? A multidisciplinary network or approach is necessary, and this network should include some different specialties as gynecologists, embryologists, virologists, infectious disease specialists, in order first to define the inclusion criteria, the infertility status, the evaluation of the HIV infection, secondly to define the ART processing, which technique are you going to use, why you are, or even or IVF, ICSI, even for fertile couples, how are you going to process sperm, and which follow-up are you going to set up for the female seronegative partner and during pregnancy. It seems that for different countries correspond different strategies. Concerning inclusion criteria, in some countries, as in France, UK or USA, HIV infection must be controlled to be included in an ART process. CD4 must be above 200. The blood viral load has to be stable for at least 6 months. The HIV strain must be detectable. The couple must have protected intercourse. And if the man is under combined antiretroviral therapy, we should ensure that the medication adherence is correct. concerting the IoT process. The technique you're going to use, YUI, IVF or ICSI, is depending on the infertility status, except perhaps in some US states where ICSI is strongly recommended. Concerning sperm washing, all the teams use a double gradient followed by a swim-up or at least two washes in order to separate plasma seminal from post-wash spermatozoa. In some countries, as in France, you are not allowed to use fresh post-wash spermatozoa. You have to freeze them before the attempt in order to look at the virus, and you are allowed to use this fraction for the attempt only if no virus is detected in the fraction. At least, concerning the female partner, some HIV testing in the female is strongly recommended. In France, you have to do it at least 15 days before the attempt and during the pregnancy. And in some countries, like in USA, it is also added during ART and perhaps pregnancy, a chemoprophylaxis for the female seronegative partner. So what are the results? As you can see, that's a major study published to date for YUI where the man is HIV positive. All the couples are fertile. And so, as you can see it, except this study, but the sample size is quite low, the pregnancy cumulative rates are high, and so this technique is efficient. But the most important thing is to know that no circumvention, either of the mother or the child, was observed to date. For the IVF or ICSI process, there are other studies, and as you can see, the pregnancy cumulative rate per cycles are good, varying from 36 to 80, nearly 90%. Here again, the most important thing is to know that no seroconversion, either of the mother or the child, was observed to date. So, in conclusion, to date, more than 3,000 couples have been treated for this indication, and mainly in YUI, leading to the birth of more than 1,000 children. And no seroconversion in female partners or newborns, either at birth or at the 3 or 6 months follow-up, was observed. So we can say that in this indication, ART is efficient and safe. But we can regret that there is no long-term follow-up of these couples and of this child. So, next, in the future, given the pivotal role of combined ART, we can wonder whether there is an alternative of ART for fertile serodiscordant couples where the man is positive. And some team have suggested to some couples unprotected sexual intercourse. Men have to be under combined antiretroviral therapy with an excellent adherence, with an undetectable blood viral load for at least 6 months, and without other sexual transmitted disease. The optimal time of conception had to be determined using LH urine test, and a fertility evaluation was performed after 6 unsuccessful attempts. And they suggested either unprotected sexual intercourse during fertile days, alone, or associated with chemoprophylaxis treatment for the negative female partner during this intercourse. This method was efficient to get pregnancy. No seroconversion was observed to date, but the risk of HIV transmission is lowered, but not equal to zero. So I think that there is still a place for ART in this indication. And according to French recommendations, YUY is strongly recommended for fertile women, and IVF ICSI in cases of unsuccessful YUR or known infertility. So, when the woman is HIV positive, the goal of ART is also to prevent the transmission of the infection. But there is still a debate concerning the possible impact of the virus on female fertility. HIV has been reported to be associated with a decrease in pregnancy rate and the likelihood of live birth as compared to non-seropositive women. But the underlying process are poorly understood. Does HIV facilitate essence of vaginal flora to the upper genital tract? Does HIV interfere ovarian function? It has been suggested that the virus was associated with an earlier age of the onset of menopause or with a premature ovarian failure. But for this point, there are contradictory results, as you can see it on this table. In this study, HIV virus does not affect either FSH or estradiol at day 3 as compared to control population, but in a recent study not published yet, we have shown that the level of estradiol at day 3 was increased in this population as compared to the control population. It has been also suggested that combined antiretroviral therapy was not always suitable for pregnancy. But this combined antiretroviral therapy has some folate antagonist effects, so there is a need for folic acid supplementation. And to date, there is no evidence for a significant increased risk of birth defects. So, what are the results? It's true that in this study, IVF and ICSI have been performed mainly for infertile women, and there are the main studies published or not yet published with a different sample size. As you can see, the clinical pregnancy per transfer varies from 11% to 33%. And when compared to a control population, this rate is either non-significantly different or always decreased as compared to the level, to the rate observed in the control population. We can also outline that here again, there is no seroconversion of the children born to date. Here again, multidisciplinary networks must be involved with different medical specialties in order to define the inclusion criteria, the infertility status, the evaluation of HIV infection. Secondly, to define the ART process. And it's true that ART in this indication is not a first line of treatment. ART is performed after unsuccessful self-insemination or fertility problems, and so the technique you're going to use is depending on the the origin of the infertility problem. And so you have always also to ensure that the follow-up is correctly performed during pregnancy, if a pregnancy occurs. Let's move on now to the second part of this presentation, and so ART in hepatitis infected patients. As you know, HCV infection is widely diffused in the world, and the prevalence of this virus varies according to 1.5 to 1.8 in the USA. The sexual transmission of the virus remains still controversial, but we know that in males infected by HCV, there are contradictory results concerning the presence of the virus. But in seminal plasma and in sperm fraction, we do believe that there is no virus, except for one study who have shown that there was some virus in seminal plasma. Concerning the IVF results, which included infertile couples, there are not many studies, but we have to know that the results were similar to those reported in Italian for the study ART registers, and there was no seroconversion of the female partner. So to date, there are some recommendations for ART in HCV discordant couples, and different societies or countries adopt different recommendations. In USA, they think that we have to applicate the same principles already discussed for HIV patients, including a multidisciplinary network in order to confirm HCV status, to obtain viral titers and function tests and gastroenterology consults. But the question of the role of ART to prevent the risk of transmission is still in debate, and they also strongly recommend to do IUI or ICSI with WASH sperm, but without any need for HCV tested post-WASH spermatozoa. In France and Italy, a multidisciplinary network is also strongly recommended, as it is for the American Society, and ART has to be performed only for subfertile or infertile couples with WASH spermatozoa when the man is infected by the virus, but there is no need for HCV tested post-WASH spermatozoa. At least concerning HPV serodiscordant couples, the sexual transmissions can be, of course, prevented by vaccinations, and the recommendations are as follows: to vaccinate the seronegative partner and to naturally conceive, or to practice ART if there is an infertility factor. So, in conclusion, what are the recommendations? First, to consider infection disease of the infected partner, to achieve safe pregnancy for woman and child, and to protect seronegative partner from viral contamination, especially in case of HIV. And so that has to be done into a multidisciplinary network in order that patients are managed on a case-by-case basis and be informed of the risk and benefit. And in France, you have to, when you perform ART in HIV or hepatitis infected patients, it has to be done with specific process in an ART laboratory dedicated to infected patients, in order to avoid cross-contamination. You have to use special procedures, separate circuits, specific processing, one incubator per virus, high security devices for cryopreservation, etc. And perhaps the next step will be to define international guidelines.